Hello everyone, it's Lindsay, and I'm back today with session two of the Only One You devotional kit from Illustrated Faith and Dayspring. I will link it down below for you so you can check it out. I did go ahead and print off the free printables on some clear label paper. These are sent to you the next day after you purchase the kit from Dayspring. I did blow them up to fill in an 8.5 by 11 sheet, so they're a little bit bigger than the file size. And then I've just pulled out some goodies that I want to use for the entry today. So I am working in Psalm 139:14, which is the verse for this card. And I'm going to kind of recreate one of the journaling cards, kind of the style of it, by mixing some stamping and some stickers and that kind of thing over in the corner. The verse is actually on the opposite page, but I've already journaled over there. So I just moved over to this page, no problem. And I'm going to do some stamping with some big brush markers. And you can see I started to stamp using a stamp block, but the stamps from Dayspring have a very slick surface. And so I have a hard time sometimes using the brush markers as an ink because the ink kind of beads up on the stamp. And so I want to be able to stamp multiple times in case I don't get a good impression. So what I have here is the Tim Holtz stamp platform. This is the mini travel size. I just got this. You've seen me in the past use a stamp positioning tool before. The one that I used to use is no longer made. It's not available. So I switched to this one. And this one's actually great for stamping in your Bible because you can see that far right-hand side of the stamp platform and the bottom side of the platform are open edged, so I can slide them into my Bible page. It's still a little bit finicky. You kind of have to play with it, but watch here. I went ahead and inked up that stamp on the lid. I know I'm out of frame, sorry, but I can go in and stamp it a second time and it's in the exact same place because I'm using that stamp positioning tool. So I will be using this more in the future so you can kind of in depth see some other ways that you can use it, but for stamping with big brush markers, it's great, or distress inks, some of those inks that you might not get a good impression with, it's great for that. So I'm leaving everything set up in the stamp platform while I work on this margin, and I'm just going to go back and forth between stamping with the platform, hand stamping, adding stickers, all that goodness. So I'm going to spell out, I am a masterpiece who is wildly loved and made to shine. And so that verse again is Psalm 139:14, and that verse says, I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works. My soul knows it very well. And so this particular day of the devotional just has us looking. I think the prompts asked us to journal some attributes of ourselves that we like, or characteristics of ourselves that we like, and that kind of thing. And so this kit is having us just look at how we are unique and recognize that God made us that way for a reason. And it's kind of fun to look at that. I mean, we were all created just the way we are for a reason. I mean, God had a plan for that. So I may be loud. I may be Italian. I may really love carbs that don't love me, but God made me that way for a reason. And I may not know fully what part of that is yet, but there is a reason, I'm sure. So talking with my hands, my mom and my family used to always just get so annoyed. I worked with patients. I worked in healthcare for a while, and patients would comment about how I'm, you know, talk with my hands and that kind of thing, and would kind of tease me about it. And now look, my whole job is my hands being on camera. So I guess he had a reason for that. So I didn't really do any journaling on this verse. I've journaled this verse several times in my journaling Bibles. So I just kind of focused on making this fun title here and just kind of had some fun playing. It wasn't my favorite page. I made some errors along the way, but like I said, when I did the unboxing of this kit, it's kind of nice about the style of this kit is it's kind of imperfect and hand done, and so your entries can be imperfect and hand done, and it's okay. And so my stamp spacing isn't perfect. I'll show you that here in a minute, and I didn't fix it. I didn't worry about it. It is what it is. Oh well. So down here, I'm stamping those two different stamps, the ampersand and made to shine. And you can see now that I've turned the stamp platform exactly how this works. And so this particular one, you can stamp with clear stamps or rubber stamps, depending on how you change the lid of the stamp platform. If you have more questions and kind of want to see that, I can do a specific video dedicated to this platform, but there are tons of those on YouTube. That's why I didn't do one, but if you guys want one, I'll do one. But you can see I just lay the stamp down on the page, flip the lid over to pick up the stamp, and then I can ink it up. I'm using an eraser to dirty the stamp a little bit. That way the ink will stick a little better. And I'm just making sure everything's lined up. There's two super strong magnets. They're covered with washi tape so that they're easier to pick up. But those hold your page down on the platform. And then you can see here I can go and double stamp and it lines it up exactly in the correct place again. So I don't have to worry about any messed up double stamping. And then I can just move along. And that top right corner, I didn't quite get spaced right. It's going to end up looking a little bit off, but that's okay. For the colors that I am using, I will link those down below. I'm going to use a combination of the big brush markers and the brush artist pens because I didn't have that particular color in a big brush marker, but it works out okay. And all the products will be linked down below for you guys, including the printer that I use, the ink that I use, the clear labels that I use, all of that's down there. So definitely check that out if you have any questions. And so I'm just kind of going along and stamping and trying to kind of eyeball things and fill it in. And I didn't really have a set idea on how I wanted this to look. I just sat down with the products and kind of went for it. So you'll see that it's not perfect, and that's okay. And it's okay if your pages aren't perfect. A lot of times I would maybe create a page that had mistakes and I wouldn't show it on my channel. But I'm learning that it's important that I do that so you guys can see they don't always come out exactly how I had envisioned at all. So you can see that spacing's a little bit off. But I'm going to go in and fill in with some of the other little individual stamps from the stamp set. And this one, it's okay if they're kind of messy. So I'm going to hand stamp them in just for the sake of time. And I am using a brush marker to do those as well. But you can see I didn't really dirty up the stamp too much. And so that ink does kind of bead up on the stamp. And that's just the nature of what these particular stamps are made out of. I have used stamps from other companies that were made out of a different material. And I had a little bit better luck stamping with brush markers. So the little wonky heart that's in there, I'm going to go fill that in, bring some yellow. And I'm trying to stick to colors that go with the kit. You'll see that this turns out looking very similar to one of the journaling cards from the kit. And just stamp, stamp, stamping. If you guys have any questions or comments, be sure to leave those down below. I do answer those. If you have questions about stamping with the brush markers or printing on label paper or using the stamp platform, a lot of times I do have videos already on a lot of that kind of stuff. So check out my Tip Tuesday playlist. I have things in there for you guys. And look back in some of my video histories. A lot of times I'll reference you to a video that I've already done if that's what will answer the question. So you can see at the top, I'm going to create a little cluster using that printable. And so I want it to kind of mimic that card so that I know that it, you know, matches session two. And so when I flip through my Bible, I'll see that this is from session two. And so I'm just looking through the different cardstock stickers. My goal is to try to use up as much of this kit as possible. I have so many leftover bits from past kits, so I need to be intentional about using things up. One thing I've done with this kit is I like to cut out the little session portion of the devotional cards and include that on my page and just kind of create a cluster that way. It is kind of a nice change up to have cardstock stickers this month instead of the clear stickers, and then you can kind of layer them a little bit easier and they just behave differently, obviously, because they're cardstock. And so it just was kind of nice to change it up, but they are included in the printables. So if you prefer to have clear stickers, you can print those out on clear label paper and you would have clear stickers. So I like that they give you the option this month. For that tab, I'm just using some EK Success powder tool to brush on the back of it to reduce any stickiness. You could just use baby powder and a fluffy brush. And so at this point, I lay that flower up at the top, but it does not stay there. It gets switched out with something else. I liked the shape of it, but the color, I didn't use that color anywhere else in this entry, so that didn't work. I'm adding a little arrow down here just to indicate that the verse is on the opposite page. And I did write the verse underneath my little margin of stamping there. Ended up going with the little cross die cut to finish off that cluster, and that is it for the entry today. So be sure to leave any questions or comments down below. Give this video a thumbs up if you were inspired. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. And until next time, thank you so much. Bye-bye.